out this cannon is what we need to go through to send down the gutter's worm. So Peter's going to send down the gutter's worm, and what that's going to do is it's going to go through and try to hook on into any solid debris. As you saw, it was a twisted metal wire thing. So we don't want solid debris here in this cannon because it could clog up the cannon if you're firing this on a regular basis. And clogging up the cannon would be bad because you could fire off a live round if you weren't loaded properly. Now once he's satisfied with that, he's going to grab the wet swab. Now what the wet swab is, it's a big dirty sponge, and he's going to send it down the muzzle and into the barrel, and this is going to do two things. First, it's going to induce moisture in the barrel to snuff out flames or embers, but it's also going to produce a vacuum. As it pulls out, you may have heard that nice thunk. Well, that means we had a nice tight seal here, and that means the thunk was the vacuum breaking. So any flames or embers in here would surely have been snuffed out. So we're safe to load in our salute charge. Now, our salute charge for you today is going to be 4 ounces of black gunpowder, and we'll send it down the barrel. Now, like I mentioned, though, salute charge means just powder, no 6-pound cannonball. And with that, though, if we wanted to fire off this cannon with a 6-pound cannonball, that would be 20 ounces of black gunpowder. That's about the size of a horse. With that, move this into firing position, kind of expedite the process here. Avoid getting rained on. Now, we're all just about ready to fire, but Peter still needs to prime the gun, so he's going to send down that pick to poke a hole in the powder charge to expose it to our ignition device. Now, it is a little wet and rainy out here today, and if we're using any other method here, perhaps you saw with maybe loose gunpowder, maybe at the fort on the mainland, at Colonial Mitchell Mackinac, or in older movies, that surely would not work. But this device we have here is called a friction primer. It's a brass hollow tube filled with black gunpowder, and at the head you have a substance called fulminate of mercury. Now this device came out in the 1840s, and it is nearly weather and foolproof because it's contained in this brass hollow tube, and you have the fulminate of mercury is friction sensitive, which will produce a flame that will go down and touch off that speaker. Now with that in mind though, this might be loud, but we're going to ask you to cover your ears up here, or get your cameras ready, and we'll see if you can cut this off. We're over 2 minutes firing this cannon. They are ready! Fire! Fire off that cannon to celebrate a birthday here and for this couple's 10th anniversary. Well, thank you so much.